Dear students, continuing on our computer graphics and visualization module 5. Today we will see the topics on Bezier spline curves and Bezier surfaces, which are used for drawing a curve and a curved surface. In computer graphics, the term spline curve refers to any composite curve which can be formed by the polynomial sections which are satisfying any specified continuity conditions at the boundary of the pieces. This spline approximation method was developed by the French engineer Pierre Bezier for the use in the automobile bodies. The Bezier splines have a number of advantages which make them very highly useful, and it is very convenient for drawing the curves and the surface design. They are very easy to implement, and because of that, these reasons, the Bezier splines are very much used in various CAD systems, in general graphics packages, and in many assorted drawing and painting packages. The number of control points to be approximated and their relative position, it is going to determine the degree of the Bezier polynomial equation. The Bezier curve, it will be specified by making use of these boundary conditions. In general, a Bezier curve can be fitted to any number of control points, although some graphic packages limit the number of control points to 4. The degree of the Bezier polynomial is determined by the number of control points approximated and its relative positions. As with the interpolation splines, we can specify the Bezier curve path in the vicinity of the control points by making use of the blending functions, a characterizing matrix, or a boundary condition. For general Bezier curves with no restrictions on the number of the control points, the blending function specification is the most convenient representation. The control points are going to determine in which direction the curve will be present. And when we are going to draw the curve will be in the neighborhood of the control points only. So let us take n plus 1 control point positions. We are having n number of control positions plus 1. Why we are having this plus 1 means, usually in the curve we are going to end up with if you are forming a circular fashion curve and all, we'll come back to the last point, which was the starting point. So we have the points as n plus 1 control point position. And every control point position is P of k. And this P of k is expressed as xk, yk, and zk, where it is the x coordinate, y coordinate, and the z coordinate for the P of k. This k here, it is varying from 0 to n. We are including 0 as well as n because we are considering n plus 1 control points. So we are having n plus 1 number of control point positions. All these points, they will be blended, they will be put together, they will be combined together to produce the vector which is called as P of u. This P of u, it is going to describe the path of the Bezier polynomial function between the points P0 and Pn. So the Pu is expressed as the summation of k is equal to 0 to n P of k, and then we have Bez of k comma n with of u, where u is varying between 0 and 1. This Bez, this is called as the Bernstein polynomial, or this is called as the blending function. The Bezier blending function is also called as the Bez of k comma n of u, where this u is varying from 0 to 1. The Bezier blending function Bez k comma n of u, it is called as the Bernstein polynomial. This Bernstein polynomial, it consists of the product of C of nk, u of k, 1 minus u to the power of n minus k. So this k, it is equal to the value which is varying from 0 to n, and u is between 0 and 1, and n is a number of, that is the number of the control points. How many number of control points we have, that is given by n. C of nk is the binomial coefficient, so it is given by n factorial divided by k factorial, n minus k factorial. So the previous equation we had this P of u. The P of u is nothing but it is the Bezier polynomial function. The Bezier polynomial function, it can be expressed in the terms of three individual curve coordinates, that is x of u, y of u and z of u. X of u is concerned with the values of the point with respect to xk. Y of u is concerned with yk and z of u is concerned with z of k. So the summation of all the x coordinate values put together multiplied with the Bernstein polynomial, that is Bz of k comma n, which is the blending function, the Bezier blending function, that will give the x of u. Similarly for the y of u and for the z of u. So the P of u is consisting of all these three parametric equations, that is x of u, y of u and z of u. In the next figure, we are going to see some of the Bezier curves for some selection of the control points. For simplicity, we will assume all the points only on the xy plane, making the z value as 0. Some special control point placements, they are going to generate some Bezier polynomials which are degenerate. That means if I am having three collinear control points, that means I am having three control points on a straight line segment, and then that set of control points, they are going to generate a straight line. Suppose if I am having the control points at the same coordinate position, this set of control points is going to produce a Bezier curve that is only a single point. These are some special conditions of the Bezier curve. In this particular figure, we can see some curves. So let us look at them one by one. First, the figure A. In this figure A, I am having three control points, P0, P1 and P2. And you can see the P1, it is pulling the curve up towards its direction. P0 is the starting point and P2 is the ending point. And P1 is another point which is lying between P0 and P2. And that is why the curve is oriented towards the P1. So you can see here, P0 is the starting point, P2 is the ending point. Because I am having P1 in this direction, the curve has been pulled up in this direction. Look at the B here. So I have P0 as one control point and P3 as the last control point. In between P0 and P3, I have P1 and P2. So P1 and P2, they are controlling the curve direction. So the curve has been dragged towards P1 and P2. It is more towards P1 because the P1 is closer here. And P2 also, we are having the control here, but it is not as much as the P1. So next we will go to the curve number C. Here we are having again four control points, but you can see that after control point P0, we are having P1, then I have the P2, then the P3. And that is why here the P0 has been curved towards the P1 and then towards P2, and it is ending at P3. So look at the curve of the picture D. So here I am having the P0, the P1 and the P2 and the P3. So the P0 and the P1, it is little far off distance over here. So the curve is similarly oriented. P1 to P2, the difference what we have, that is very small here, and that is why the curve is less curved over here. And finally, this particular curve is coming to the end at point P3. So you can see the E curve. What is happening here? We are having 5 control points: P0, P1, P2, P3 and P4. So based on their positions, the curve has been pulled towards the control point. So this is a two-dimensional Bezier curves, which are generated by making use of 3 control points, 4 control points and 5 control points. So the dashed line here is indicating the control point positions, and the curve which has been drawn, it is the curve which has been controlled by the control points, depending upon how many control points we are having here. It may be 3, 4 or 5. Based on that, the curve position will be drawn as per the control point. Now let us look at one example program which is going to generate a Bezier curve. This Bezier blending function, it is going to generate a two-dimensional cubic Bezier spline curve, and it is going to have 4 control points. These 4 control points are defined in the XY plane by making the Z value as 0. We will have 1000 pixel positions plotted at the end of the program, which will give us a curve path. This has been drawn with a pixel width of 4. So here we come across a function called as the binomial coefficient, which is used for calculating the binomial coefficients. We have another function which is called as the compute Bezier point, which is used for calculating the curve path coordinate positions. And we have another procedure which is called as the Bezier, which will mark all the pixel positions on the display here by making use of the point plotting routines. That means by making use of the GL vertex command, this Bezier is going to draw the points on the display. So this is the output what we are going to get at the end of this Bezier curve program. This curve has been drawn by making use of 1000 points. So on this line, every point here, it has been marked. This point will be having x direction and the y direction. So this is the stopping point and this is the starting point. I'm going to have one point over here, one control point over here, above this curve here. So that this curve is pulled to this direction. I'm going to have one more control point on this place here, so that this curve will be pulled to downward direction. So using 4 control points, so we'll have one at the beginning, one at the ending, and 2 points in between. So by making use of 4 control points, we can draw this particular curve. Each individual point here, it has been marked with a pixel width of 4, and that is why it is looking little thicker over here. It is not a thin line. Every point here is marked with a pixel width of 4 pixels. That means 4 by 4 pixels are considered as 1 pixel, and this curve has been drawn. Every point is marked here and the curve has been drawn. So totally by using 4 control points, 1000 points have been plotted to form a curve. The input is the 4 control points and the output is 1000 point curve. That means you are having a curve drawn by using 1000 points. This program part by part. So at the beginning we have the usual library files included. Then I am having the width and height of the window. Also I am giving a clipping window. So minimum is given by minus 50, minus 50, and maximum is plus 50, plus 50. I will take one class here which is called as world coordinate point 3D, and it will be having 3 values, that is x, y, and z. Next, I am having the init function. This init function, it is going to set the display window to white color by making use of the GL clear color. Then I have one more function which is called as plot the point. This plot point function, you can see it is accepting one variable of type wc.3d, which we just saw now. It is a class which is consisting of x, y, and z values. That means bz curve point is one variable, or it is one object which is having x value, y value, and z value. So in this case, because we are using only a two-dimensional curve, we are only considering the x and the y value, keeping the z value as 0. So that is why I am making use of this GL vertex 2f instead of 3f. And then a point is marked with respect to the x and the y direction by making use of the primitive GL points. This Bezier curve generating program is having one function called as the binomial coefficient. This binomial coefficient, it is having two parameters. The first one is n and the second one is the c. N is integer and c is also a pointer here, which will be consisting of, which can hold three values. That means c of 0, c of 1, and c of 2. The binomial coefficient values it can hold. So this binomial coefficient function, it is finding the n factorial divided by k factorial into n minus k factorial. So to compute the binomial coefficient, this function has been used. We have a function called as compute bz point, which is taking multiple parameters. The first parameter u, it is lying between 0 and 1. And then we are having bz point, which is consisting of three values x, y, and z, because it belongs to wc.3d. Then I have n control points. That means the number of control points what I am having, it is equal to 4. Then I have one more array which is called as the control points. This control points is of type wc.3d. It will have the all the four control points values. Then I am having another array called as the c, which is used for computing the binomial coefficient. That means when I am computing the c of k, I am going to make use of this c. And then the k value will be 0, 1, and 2. It depends upon how many control points I am having. So if I am having four control points, then the k value will be varying from 0 to less than control points. That means all the control points I am going to make use of. So initially the Bezier point x, Bezier point y, and the Bezier point z, it is equal to 0. Then I am going to compute the value for each of these x, y, and z. We know the values for this x, y, and z by the formula x of u, it is equal to summation of k is equal to 0 to n x of k b is z of k comma n of u, where b is z of k comma n of u, it is equal to the Bezier blending function. The Bezier blending function or the Bernstein polynomial, it depends upon the binomial coefficient. So it depends upon the binomial coefficient, and also we should go for taking the control point. So x of u, y of u, and z of u is computed here as bz point of x, bz point of y, bz point of z. The Bezier function, it is accepting an array of the control points which will be having x, y, z values. Then the number of control points, which is equal to 4. And then I am having n Bezier curve points. That means I want to mark 1000 points. So here n Bezier curve points, it will be equal to 1000. So then the C array will be having a place for storing value which is equal to the number of control points. That means C will be equal to 4, where we will be having C of 0, C of 1, C of 2, and C of 3. then I run a for loop for 1000 points plus 1, because we are starting from 0. So n plus 1, so it will be equal to 1000 plus 1, and then I'm going to compute the Bezier points and plot them by using the compute Bezier point and the plot point function. The display function is a function in which we are going to make use of the initial condition for the control points and the curve points. Here we will assume 4 control points. So the n control points is equal to 4. And then I am going to draw the curve by using 1000 curve points. So I am taking the count as 1000 for n Bezier curve points. For the 4 control points, I have to specify the position. So because it is a 2D curve, I am going to make use of only x and y value, making the z value as 0 for all the 4 control points. So the control points, 4 control points are mentioned here. So it is given in terms of x, y and z value. After clearing the display window and setting the point size as 4, so that the point will be little thicker, that is why here the GL point size is made as 4. And then the curve what we are going to draw, each of these points will be having the color as red. So we can set the point color to be as red by using this GL color 3F function. And then I am going to call the Bezier function by passing the control points, that means the array in which I am having these 4 values, that is passed, and then n control points which is equal to 4, n Bezier curve points which is equal to 1000, it is being passed to the Bezier function. The window reshape function is given by the window reshape FCN here. It is consisting of 2 parameters, that is the width and the height. So we are having here the viewport whose origin is at 0,0 with its width and the height given by the parameters in the window reshape function. So because we are going for a projection, that is the projecting the output, we need to have the GL matrix mode, GL projection, and we should make use of the GL load identity. Also I am having here GLU ortho 2D, which is going to specify a 2-dimensional window with the x minimum and the y minimum, x max and y max. We are going to clear the frame buffer bit by making use of the GL clear, so that we are going to get the new output without disturbance from the previous output. So lastly, we are going to write the main function, but this is the first function which will be executed. So as usual, we will be having the init statements for initializing the command line arguments and a single window, because there is no animation, just a curve is drawn. And the color what we are going to use is the RGB. The initial window position, it is placed at 50 and 50. We can change and we can move it, but the initially it is going to be placed on my monitor window at a position x value 50 and y value 50. So the window size is given by previously what was specified in the program, the window width and the window height, 600 by 600. So the window size is given by 600 by 600. And the title for this program, for the output, that is Bezier curve. So then we call the initialization, the display function and the reshape function. And at last, we are going to end it by using the glut main loop. The display function in turn calls all other functions and it is going to give the output. That means it is going to draw a curve, which will be the simple sine wave like curve. This is the program flow. First, the main function is called. The main function calls the display function. The display function calls the Bezier function. The Bezier function calls the binomial coefficient function. After the binomial coefficients are computed, then the compute Bezier point is called. And lastly, we are having the plot point. This compute Bezier point and the plot point, they are put in a while loop. They are put in a for loop, and it is called for 1000 times. That means, because we want to mark 1000 points to form the curve. So here, the compute Bezier point and the plot point, they are included in a for loop, which will be executed for 1000 times. For this program, four control points have been given. These four control points are at positions minus 40, minus 40, that is 0.1. And 0.2 is at minus 10, 200. 0.3 is at 10, minus 200. And the 0.4 is at plus 40, plus 40. So you can visualize this one to be a curve which is having a sine wave like drawing, because we have the control points present at this position. So the control points are going to control how the curve will be drawn. The curve is drawn in the neighborhood of the control points. The Bezier function parameters. These are the parameters what will be present in your Bezier function. The first one is the control points, that is array of size 4, which is consisting of 4 control points. These 4 control points will be having the x and y values, where the z value will be equal to 0. N control points is equal to 4, it is given the count of the control points. N Bezier curve points is equal to 1000, that is the number of points which will be used to mark the curve. The compute Bezier point function, it is accepting 5 parameters. The first one is u, that is the ratio between 0 and 1, so which is got by k by 1000, where k is between 0 to 1000. And then Bezier point is array of 3 values. We have x, y and z value. N control points is equal to 4. Control points is equal to the array of 4 control points. And c is an array to store the binomial coefficients. The binomial coefficient is a function which takes 2 parameters, that is n and c. N is the number of control points minus 1, which is equal to 4 minus 1, which is equal to 3. And c is a 3 element array which will store the binomial coefficients. That is, we'll have c of 0, c of 1 and c of 2. Some of the properties of the Bezier curves are listed now. So one of the property is the Bezier curve will connect the first and the last control point. That means for any Bezier curve, p of 0, it is equal to p naught, and p of 1 is equal to pn. The values for the parametric first derivative of a Bezier curve can be calculated by making use of the control point coordinates, that is p naught and p1, p2, like this up till pn. So p dash of 0, it is equal to minus n p naught plus n p1. So p dash of 1, it will be equal to minus n p of n minus 1 plus n pn. Similarly, the second derivatives of the Bezier curve at the end points, they can be calculated as p double dash of 0 and p double dash of 1. P double dash of 0, it is given in terms of p0, p1 and p2. The p double dash of 1 is given in terms of pn, pn minus 1 and pn minus 2. So when we multiply the value of the n and n minus 1 with the points, we can get the parametric second derivative of the Bezier curve. For the first derivative, we can see that the slope at the beginning of the curve is along the line which is going to join the first two control points, and the slope at the end of the curve is along the line which is going to join the last two endpoints. Another important property of the Bezier curve is it is going to lie within the convex polygon boundary of the control points. That means when we are going to add all the the b is z of k comma n, that is the Bernstein's polynomial, or we can say the Bezier constant. When we are going to add them, it will be equal to 1. So that any curve position is always equal to 1 when we are going to add the sum of the control point positions. This property is very useful to make sure that we are going to get the curve in a very smooth fashion without any errors. There won't be any erratic, there won't be any disturbance. The oscillations won't be here and there. The points won't be here and there. It will give you a very smooth output. A closed Bezier curve can be generated when we make the last control point same as the first control point. So look at this figure where we have 6 control points, P0, P1, P2, P3, P4 and P5. If I am making the P0 same as P5, so then I am going to get a closed Bezier curve. This is because we are having the P0 same as P5. If we specify more number of control points at a single coordinate position, it will give more weight to that position. So you can look in this picture here. A single coordinate position is input as 2 control points. Here the P1 is same as P2. So 2 control points are present at 1 coordinate position. And you can see the resulting curve. It is pulled nearer to this position because of the weight of P1 and P2. Because we have 2 control points, the curve will be pulled towards this control point because of the double effect of the P1 as well as the P2. To get the first order continuity between the curve sections, we can pick the control points P0 dash and P1 dash for the next curve section, which is along the same straight line, has the control points Pn minus 1 and Pn as shown in the next picture. We'll see the picture how it will be there. So if the first curve section is having n number of control points and the next section is having n dash number of control points, then we can match the curve tangents by placing the control point P1 dash at the position which is given by Pn and Pn minus 1, n and n dash. We can compute this one, and that will be the new point P1 dash. This P1 dash can be identified to combine one curve with another curve. So to simplify where we have to place the P1 dash, we can go for finding the geometric continuity and then we can place the P1. This is anywhere along the line of Pn minus 1 and the point Pn. So in this picture we are having two curves. The first curve is P0, P1 and P2. The next curve is P0 dash, P1 dash, P2 dash and P3 dash. So if I want to get the continuity, we are going to pick the control points, that is P0 dash and P1 dash. And then we are going to continue on P2, that is P2 and P1, that is for the previous section. So the P0 dash and P1 dash are for the second curve. The ending points of the first curve are P1 and P2. So we are going to see that a straight line will be formed, or you can tell when we connect these points, that is P1, P2, P0 dash and P1, they have to form a straight line. So if the first curve is having n number of control points and the second one is having n dash number of control points, we can match the curve tangents. That means we can go for marking one point called as P1 dash. This P1 dash can be expressed in the form of the previous curves Pn and Pn minus 1, as well as n and n dash, where n is the number of control points for the first curve. Here it is equal to 3, and n dash it is equal to 4. It is the number of control points on the second curve. Many graphics packages, they provide the functions for displaying only the cubic splines. So we are going to design with flexibility and we are going to avoid the increasing calculations which are required for higher order polynomials. The cubic Bezier curves are generated by making use of four control points. The four blending functions of the g, n of u, that is the Bernstein's polynomial. Bz of k, n of u, here it can be the value of the n, it can be given as 3. When we give the value of the n as 3 and the k value is taken from 0, 1, 2 and 3, we get these four equations. That is Bz of 0, 3, Bz of 1, 3, Bz of 2, 3 and Bz of 3, 3. So depending upon the binomial coefficient, it would be simplified and we are going to get this as the equation in 33. The curves for the four cubic Bezier blending functions, they are given in the next slide. The form of the blending functions are going to determine how the control points are going to influence the shape of the curve for the values of the parameter u, which is between the range 0 and 1. When u is equal to 0, the only non-zero blending function is Bz of 0, 3, which has the value 1. At u is equal to 1, the only non-zero function is Bz of 3, 3 of 1, which is equal to 1. So, a cubic Bezier curve will always begin at the control point P0 and end at the control point P3. Because here we are having one and Bz of 2, 3 is maximum at u is equal to 2 by 3. These are the four Bezier blending functions for the cubic curves when the n value is equal to 3. The first one is the Bz of 0, 3. And the second one is the Bz of 1, 3. Then we have Bz of 2, 3 and Bz of 3, 3. These are got from the previous blending functions. The Bezier blending function equation, these are following. So you can see how they are going to behave individually. You can see that when u is equal to 0, the non-blending function, that is the non-zero blending function is Bz of 0, 3, it is going to have the value as 1. At u is equal to 1, Bz of 3, 3, that is equal to 1. So the blending function Bz of 1, 3, it is maximum at u is equal to 1 by 3 and Bz of 2, 3 is maximum at u is equal to 2 by 3. So these are the Bezier curve blending functions for the cubic curves. At the end positions of the cubic Bezier curve, the first derivatives, they are given by P dash of 0, which is in terms of P1 and P0, P dash of 1, which is in terms of P3 and P2. The second derivative, it is given by P double dash of 0 and P double dash of 1. The P double dash of 0 depends on P0, P1 and P2 and P double dash of 1 depends on P1, P2 and P3. This Bezier curve function, we can go for the matrix representation also. So when we are expanding the polynomial expressions for the blending functions, that is BEZ functions, we can go for restructuring these equations and we can find what is the value for P of u. So you can see that the P of U is given in terms of U matrix, M of BZ matrix, and the points, the 4 points, because this is a cubic Bezier curve, we are going to have 4 points, P0, P1, P2, and P3. Where the Bezier matrix itself, it is in terms of the numbers what are given in this matrix, that is in the equation 35. If I want to get a Bezier surface, then what I have to do? We know now Bezier curve. So what we are going to do? We are going to combine two sets of Bezier curve to get one surface. So the vector what can be got after blending these two functions, that means we have two blending functions, that is Bz of j, m and Bz of k, n. So Bz j, m, it is for the first curve, Bz of k, n, it is for the second curve. So we can go for blending these two functions to get a Bezier surface. Now the Bezier surface will be a function called as P of u v, because it is consisting of two curves, u curve and v curve. So we will be having P of u v, and the summation of P of j k in terms of j is equal to 0 to m and k is equal to 0 to n. Where this P of j k, it is going to specify the location of the m plus 1 by n plus 1 control points. Now the control points also are going to increase based on the m and the n. So we will be having m plus 1 cross n plus 1 control points. So in the next slide, we will see the two Bezier surface plots. The control points are connected by dashed lines, and the solid lines are the curves of the constant u and the constant v. Each curve of the constant u is plotted by varying v between the range 0 and 1, with u fixed at one of the value in this unit interval. So the curves of the constant v, they are plotted similarly by making use of the u between 0 and 1, where v will be fixed. This picture, it is depicting the Bezier surface. This Bezier surface is got by making use of two Bezier curves. So by making use of a P of uv, where you will be having u varying v fixed, v varying u fixed. In that way, we are going to fix the surface here. That means we are going to form the Bezier surface. So the A surface, it is having 9 control points which are arranged in a 3 cross 3 mesh. So depending upon where these control points are present, the curve will be drawn. So you can see here the dashed lines are going to connect the control points, and the solid lines are connecting the curve. So the second one, that is the B, it is consisting of 16 control points, and these 16 control points, they are arranged in a 4 cross 4 mesh. So we can construct a Bezier surface by making use of two Bezier curves. The Bezier surfaces have the same properties like the Bezier curves, and they are providing a very convenient method for designing many applications. To specify a 3D coordinate position for the control point, we can first construct a rectangular grid in the XY plane. Then we can choose the elevations above the XY plane at the grid intersections as the Z coordinate values for the control points. This will be helpful for designing a 3D. We can assume the XY to be as the ground, and then when we are going to build above the XY, it becomes the 3D view. The surface patches, they can be represented with polygons and shadings and also by making use of different rendering techniques, what we have learnt in our previous topics. The surface on the next slide, it is going to indicate a Bezier surface, which is formed by making use of two Bezier curves. So like a curve only, we can get a smooth transition when we are moving from one curve to another. When we are going to establish a zero order and the first order continuity at the boundary line. Zero order continuity is obtained when we are going to match the control points at the boundary. And the first order continuity is obtained when we are going to choose the control points along a straight line across the boundary, and we are going to maintain a constant ratio of a line segments which are present on the same line for each set of specified control point across the section boundaries. So when we follow these conditions, that is a zero order continuity to match the control points and first order continuity to select an appropriate control point across the boundary, then we can have a smooth surface across both the section boundaries. So this is a composite Bezier surface, because we are going to construct this Bezier surface by making use of two Bezier curves. By making use of two Bezier sections, we are going to join them at a boundary line. We can see the boundary line here. So we have a boundary line. Along this boundary line, we are going to combine these two surfaces. The dashed lines, what we are having here, those are the lines which are going to connect the control points. So the black dots, what we are having here, all these are the control points. And the first order continuity is established by making the ratio of the length L1 to the length L2. That means on this side, we are having the ratio of the length as L1. Here we have the ratio as L2. So both of them should be made as constant for this collinear line of control points across the boundary between the surface sections. Then we can go for having a Bezier surface. So these are the examples for the Bezier surface and Bezier spline curve. So we come to the end of the class for today. Class, we are going to read some of the, or we are going to study some of the APIs which are concerned with this Bezier curves and Bezier surfaces. Thank you.